Chinese astronauts are stuck on the space station, reminiscent of the problems involving Boeing's Starliner. Could SpaceX's Dragon provide assistance? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. In a previous report, it was highlighted that China's Shenzhou 20 spacecraft faced a challenging situation related to space debris. I call it challenging because the incident occurred while the spacecraft was still docked at the Tiangong space station. This incident could have caused a leak in the spacecraft, posing a significant hazard to the crew's planned return to Earth. The scenario became more complicated when problems arose following the arrival of a new crew, Shenzhou 21, at Tiangong. This unexpected overlap between the two teams at the station increased the demand for living space, food, and other essential supplies. Interestingly, the presence of two crews could also facilitate more effective spacecraft problem solving, as more personnel would be available to troubleshoot and devise solutions. China has utilized social media platforms like Weibo to keep the public and the aerospace community informed about the situation. On November 5th, when Shenzhou 20 was initially scheduled to return, the China Manned Space Agency, CMSA, indicated that the spacecraft was suspected of being struck by small space debris and that an impact assessment and analysis were currently underway. In an update on the 11th, the CMSA provided a more comprehensive picture. Regarding the Shenzhou 20 manned spacecraft return mission, the operation is based on the principles of prioritizing life and safety. Emergency protocols and strategies have been immediately implemented. Detailed simulation analysis, testing, and safety evaluation of the Shenzhou 20 spacecraft are currently underway. The Shenzhou 20 astronaut team's return plan has been thoroughly reviewed, with all tests, joint debugging, and evaluations coordinated according to established procedures. Key product status and quality checks have been arranged, and the designated landing site is undergoing intensive training to prepare for the return mission. All activities are proceeding consistently and in an organized manner according to the established plan. Furthermore, the CMSA aimed to reassure the international aerospace community by stating, "Currently, the space station assembly is functioning normally and has the capability to support a 2-astronaut crew in orbit."
The Shenzhou 20 astronaut team is functioning and residing normally while collaboratively performing in-space scientific research with the Shenzhou 20 astronaut team. Although this brings a level of positivity, there is still ambiguity surrounding the true condition of the spacecraft. Evidently, this scenario resembles some obstacles encountered previously. The Shenzhou 20 crew has been in orbit longer than initially anticipated, similar to the Starliner CFT-1 mission from last year, where astronauts faced extended delays as well. However, the underlying reasons differ. The Shenzhou 20 is contending with external debris damage, which may include possible leaks, whereas Starliner's postponement stemmed from internal technical problems like thruster issues and helium leaks. How might China address the current complication? It appears that internal management will be prioritized first. One possibility is for both crews to collaborate in diagnosing the Shenzhou 20 spacecraft, aiming to facilitate a planned return. This method, however, comes with significant downsides. The additional crew aboard Tiangong elevates the demand for food and other life-sustaining resources, possibly requiring immediate cargo missions to replenish supplies for the station. Another alternative could be to employ a different spacecraft for the return journey. China might dispatch a new vehicle to safely bring the Shenzhou 20 team back, while allowing the compromised Shenzhou 20 spacecraft to return without astronauts. This is akin to the contingency strategy of Starliner. Alternatively, in pressing situations, the Shenzhou 20 crew could utilize Shenzhou 21 for their return while the crew of Shenzhou 21 remains available for a new vehicle. Both solutions present their own risks. The first method prolongs the Shenzhou 20 crew's stay in space without any assurance of when a rescue vehicle might be operational. Readying an emergency crewed spacecraft is intricate, as it demands thorough refurbishments and safety assessments. Currently, Shenzhou 18 and 19 are undergoing refurbishment, but there are plans for 19 to serve Shenzhou 22, leaving 18 as the sole feasible rescue option. The second approach risks leaving the Shenzhou 21 crew stranded. In human spaceflight endeavors, a dependable return spacecraft must be stationed at all times due to potential emergencies. No mission can safely depart with astronauts lacking access to a vessel capable of evacuation. Even if arrangements for a replacement vehicle are made, the logistics of getting it to Tiangong introduce further obstacles. To ensure adequate space for the return initiative, the new craft must launch without a crew. Operating a spacecraft without onboard control personnel brings certain risks, as ground teams cannot fully manage every in-orbit procedure. Even if two operators oversee the vehicle during launch and docking, the return voyage could become tight and challenging to maneuver.
Given these complexities, the most sensible approach may be to manage the situation internally and delay the rescue until the Shenzhou 20 spacecraft issues are fully resolved. While this places additional strain on station resources and creates uncertainty regarding timing, it ensures that the mission can proceed safely without further complications. If internal measures prove inadequate, external assistance may need to be considered. The most sensible option appears to be SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft. Starliner is currently experiencing technical difficulties stemming from last year's incident, and Russia's Soyuz spacecraft faces its own set of challenges. Dragon has a track record of reliability and adaptability, making it a prime choice for emergency crew evacuation. If internal measures prove unsuccessful, China will need to seriously evaluate Dragon as an alternative solution. Beyond the urgent rescue, this situation underscores the need for increased transparency and international cooperation in space-related activities. While China and the United States compete on various fronts, space exploration remains a collective human endeavor, and issues like space debris impact all nations. By establishing coordinated communication and response strategies, the global community can handle such situations more efficiently and safely. The broader implications suggest that a dedicated space rescue fleet may be necessary. As the number of satellites and debris in orbit continues to increase, the dangers to manned spacecraft also increase. In such a scenario, SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft would likely play a crucial role due to its established operational reliability and adaptability. If implemented, this would be a significant advancement for Dragon and the global spaceflight community. While the likelihood of needing Dragon 4 rescue mission is currently very remote, it remains a potential option following last year's Starliner incident. The primary focus remains ensuring the safe return of the Shenzhou 20 crew. Regardless of the outcome, it is crucial for the international space community to support and closely monitor these initiatives. Should China consider using Dragon if the situation warrants it? Share your thoughts by answering yes or no in the comments below. Whatever the decision, the most important aspect is to extend our best wishes and support to the Shenzhou 20 crew to ensure their safe return to Earth. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next episode.